So you want to manifest someone who has actually cheated on you, right? Okay, this whole video is going to be on this topic only, and I will try to make you clear whether you actually should manifest this person or not. Okay, I have actually made some points, okay, and we will talk about this. Now after that, if you feel still you want to manifest this person, you can go ahead. Okay, whatever you are doing is actually getting you onto track, I can say, and nobody is wrong here. Okay, yes, you can still manifest this person who has actually cheated on you. Okay, this is a simple answer I want to give, but this can be complicated when you go and try manifestation techniques to manifest them. Okay, so first of all, I have actually made points. I will talk about this, and you need to listen to this, listen to the whole video. This is very important, guys, because most of you are trying to manifest a person who has initially cheated on you, and you are in no contact since 1 year or 2 years or 6 months. Okay, so let's start. Yeah, yes guys, do not forget to subscribe and click the bell icon of my channel so that you can be notified about the manifestation techniques and the law of attraction videos I share, because I am going to share all the practical I am going to share actually my practical point of view on this. Okay, so yeah, let's start it. Okay, first point I have made is, are you able to forget the hurt, whatever hurt this person has given you? Okay, most of the time, yes, they cheat your person or anyone who has cheated on their person. Okay, most of the people who cheat have such excuses. I actually want to share, they will actually make excuses to you like, you are not worthy. This is the most common excuse a cheater gives. Okay, that you are not worthy, you are like this, you are like that, and I don't want to be with you, and I loved you so much, but you are not worth my love. Okay, okay, this person is definitely a narcissist. I thought you were different. I don't know how can a person be different for someone. Okay, if you are different, then this is a uniqueness. Okay, this should be accepted. Okay, if this person, okay, first point, you are not worthy, they are going to make excuse like this, and I thought you are different than others. How they want you to be different, I don't know. If they start the relationship, then they should be careful and responsible of what they say, because being actually entering a relationship is not a game. Okay, that we will enter the relationship, then we will know each other. No, you have to know each other, then you have to enter a relationship so that the other person cannot feel that, okay, this I am not worthy or something like that, I should be different for my partner. No, if you choose a partner, then first of all, know that partner, so that you cannot come to the stage where you have to say like this, you are definitely a cheater, if a cheater is watching this video. And if somebody, you know, has been cheated or had been cheated in the past, yes, the cheater make excuses, you are not worthy, I thought you were different. Third point is, you are very toxic. Mostly, I'm not saying that only men, but women too, but mostly men have these dialogue that you are toxic, this relationship is going toxic. I don't know what kind of toxicity they are talking about, that if you are not feeling good and you have to say that, okay, I'm not feeling good, this incident happened with you or your friend or your or a family members of yours, and I don't feel good about it, and you feel that this person is so close to you and you can share everything, and this person says that you are toxic because this person has cheated on you and this person has to leave you. Okay, and at that time this person says that, okay, the relationship is going toxic, you are toxic, and I don't want to be with you, this person was never in love with you at first place. Okay, I'm sorry for the background noise. Okay, you fight over each other's friends, okay? I mean, first of all, guys, if you are in a relationship, your partner should be the important person for you, and you should be the most important person for your partner and nobody else. Because if this person has decided to be in a relationship with you, then in the future, when this person is 60, nobody will be there for this person but you, okay? So you are the most important person. This is the practical thing. So you cannot fight over some third party. All are third parties. Even the parents are third parties now, because you both are going to be forever when these friends or parents are not going to be with them. I am practical. You have to be respectful for others, friends, parents, but these third party, if come in between you and this person leaves you for them, then this person is a cheater, okay? This person is a cheater. This person is a toxic person for you, for anyone, okay? Yes, last point I have to cover is, sometimes when they are going to leave you, they will say, you know, I am not worthy for you. You deserve better. Because their time is over with you and they have cheated on you. And you know this. This is why they can say, you know, I am not worthy for you. So I actually search for somebody, you know, of my equal, of my level, and I'm not worthy for you. I want, because, you know, the loyalty you are giving to them, okay, I can say, is difficult for them to go on that level. And then yes, this person is not actually worthy of you, because this person is going to cheat on you again, okay? So these are the points of cheaters' excuses, okay? Now I have you know, something more to tell you. I have written so that I should not forget anything, any information, okay? Yes, of course, when a person loves you, guys, they will never make excuses, such stupid excuses, to not be with you. Can you imagine? You are here trying to manifest this person, even if this person has cheated on you, and this person cannot be with you because of some other kind of third party. Maybe friends, parents, maybe because they feel that you are boring or something. First of all, when you come into a relationship, okay, first of all, you need to be friends and know each other. Then you should enter any kind of relationship. So this does not happen. If you can see your parents, they are still together. Why? Because they actually love each other. And they know, understand that everybody is different. They accept each other. This is why their marriages work. Okay, and now there are a lot of options. You know, this is one more point I have not noted here, that they treat you like option. I talk to so many people, okay? I will get so... any other person, why should I care about this person? I will just be narcissist. I tell this person that it was all your fault and I will leave this person and will go to my next option, okay? So now, if I, you know, I have cleared this all, now do you want to manifest this person? If not, then please try to manifest somebody else. And, you know, you can use scripting where you can write the whole paragraph of what kind of desired person you want. Still, you have that patience that, okay, I want this person and I desire this person and I will only manifest this person because I find there is kind of connection. It happens that there is a kind of connection, but the other person, due to in this matrix 3D world, you know, their mind becomes toxic, or they go into that kind of societal pressure. I don't know what word I should use, but they actually gets drawn into all kind of 3D matrix, whatever it can be said. So yes, there can be past life connections, there can be twin flame connection, there can be, I don't think there are soulmates, different kind of soulmates. I think everyone is your soulmate, so I will only go with past life connection and twin flame connections, okay? Yes, there can be a connection So yes, if you feel yes, there is kind of connection. So yes, what you need to do is work on your inner healing of negativity and forgive this person first of all before you try any manifestation technique. And manifestation technique is not any kind of magic. When you are healed from all kind of negativity and past traumas this person has given to you, only you can manifest this person. Because when you are waiting, okay, I am using this manifestation technique so the result should come. No, this manifestation technique, any manifestation technique you are going to use is just to train your subconscious mind so that you can have faith in this universe, whole universe, that yes, it is going to happen. Then only the manifestation will happen. Okay, but most of you, I will straightforwardly say that most of you use manifestation technique that, okay, due to this, something will happen magical and I am waiting for the desire because I am using manifestation technique. No, guys, manifestation techniques are just to train your subconscious mind so that your mind only speaks your desire in present tense. That too. Okay? You can use affirmation, I have joyful and happy relationship with my partner. This partner is your ex who has cheated on you, but now you have forgiven this person and you do not have to deal with negativity. You are not dealing with the negativity, you are not dwelling in the past. Now you are all clear and the past is not coming. Then definitely you can manifest this person from using, you know, by practicing any manifestation technique. Okay, because the manifestation technique will help you in training your subconscious mind that yes, it will happen. It is happening right now, you have to feel. Or in divine timing, it is definitely going to happen, you have to feel. Now the negativity is not here that this person has cheated on you. Now you can manifest. Now, if the negativity is not there that this person, you know, manipulated me to believe that I was always wrong and this is why this person left me. If this negativity is not coming, again, now you can manifest. But when you are using manifestation technique and after 4 days or 2 days, again the negativity, you are actually dwelling in the negativity. No, you cannot manifest anything, any of your desire, not only this X, but nothing. If you are confused whether it will happen, whether it will not happen, then no, you are not going to manifest. And from my personal advice, if a person has given you such trauma that you cannot forget the past, please do not manifest this person. It is my humble request, manifest a desired person who will actually will help you in your success and progress, and they will not, you know, make you believe that you are not worthy, you are so toxic, you are something like this, something that, which is all negative. Because if a person who is actually telling all such kind of thing to make you feel hurt, to make you feel emotionally negative, this person doesn't love you, guys. Yes, of course, you can change the behavior too. But again, this question comes, are you able to forget the hurt given by this person? Then yes, you can change the behavior of this person. You can manifest this ex back. But if you cannot have that patience right now, first work on your negativity level and then try to manifest this person who has cheated on you or this person who was very toxic. I hope I have made you, you know, I have made you clear in this video that if you want to manifest, again, if you want to manifest a person who has somehow cheated on you in the past, if you want to manifest this person, first of all, work on healing the past traumas, which is, you know, connected with this person so that you can forgive this person and you can let go of the past and everything is clear. Your mind is clear. Your heart is clear for this person and you are manifesting this person. Okay? Got it clear? Thank you so much, guys.